Good morning, McKnight.
Good morning, McKnight.
Hi, Dr. Schutz.
Good morning, Miss Tutson. How are you?
I'm good. How's it going at the Schutz House?
Oh, you know, it's tough to be a teacher and a student and a principal all at home at the same time.
Yes, we're going to have to interview the girls to see if you guys, if you're a good teacher or not.
I don't think I am. Teachers at McKnight are probably a whole lot better than I'm doing right
now. Yeah, I would say our teachers are pretty amazing.
Absolutely.
So today is Wednesday, March 25th, and it is National Waffle Day.
You don't say. I have my waffle iron right here, all ready for breakfast.
Oh.
Get this, Mrs. Hudson. I almost put on one of my favorite t-shirts today. Look at that.
Waffles?
Pancakes with abs.
Waffles are just pancakes with abs. You are so funny. Well, we love waffles. Cash has really just started eating breakfast food, and he loves chocolate chip pancakes. Chocolate chip waffles. So check out this quick video of how we eat waffles at the Hudson.
Good morning, McKnight. Today on National Waffle Day, Addie is here to tell you how at the Hudson's how we like to make waffles. So Cash just recently really learned to like waffles, and he really likes chocolate chip waffles. But Addie likes to spice her waffles up a little bit. So, Addie, what do you like to put on your waffle? Whipped cream, strawberries, and M&M's. Okay, so what are you going to put on first, Addie?
Whipped cream.
Whipped cream? Okay, you need help? You don't want any help? Okay. You might need some. This is good for a mom and dad to help you with. Ready? You tell me when to stop. Oh. Cash, would you like to try some? Here, bud. Want to try some whipped cream? Put your strawberries on. Here, buddy. Gosh, right here. No, you just want the candy. Here you go. All right, keep going, Addie. All right, what's on next?
M&M's
on waffles. All right, McKnight, I hope you enjoy your waffles this morning and you're able to celebrate National Waffle Day.
All right, we have some birthdays.
We do, and you know what, Mrs. Hudson? I made a mistake in yesterday's announcements. I have the wrong month for the birthdays. I really need Mrs. Mazza and Mrs. Bookliner's help. Since they're not there, I apologize to the students that I announced yesterday, but maybe they got an extra present or two, or maybe
yes,
some extra birthday cake, even though it wasn't their birthday.
Double birthdays for them. We do miss Mrs. Mazza and Mrs. Bookliner. They really helped Dr. Sheet and I a ton.
They do.
And Mrs. Ravenstein, we miss her as well.
We do. But yesterday's birthday, Tuesday, March 24th, it should have been Silas from 4E and Grace from 5A. Happy birthday. Sorry I missed it yesterday. Today's birthdays are Eli in 1B, Jenny in 3A, and Andy in 4E. Happy birthday to everyone.
Mistakes are proof that you are trying and growing. So it was a good learning opportunity for you, Dr. Shoup.
It's
a good thing. Happy birthday, guys. So today we are super excited. It is our first official day of remote learning.
Right. We're going from our flexible instruction days, which we had on Monday and Tuesday, to our remote learning today. So boys and girls, when you log on to your teacher's website, on the left-hand side of the page, you're going to see a little button that says remote learning. You're going to click on that button, and it's going to give you all of your assignments for Wednesday and for the rest of the week as well. And also, don't forget to make sure that you check in for your attendance every day. And Mom and Dad, I know there's been some problems over the past couple of days. Our IT department's working on that. So please keep trying for each other that attendance through your Tiger ID. And we're working out some of those kinks every day, but we really appreciate your patience with it.
Yes, thank you, Mom and Dad, for your patience with attendance. Each day, again, is our proof that we are improving each and every day. So thanks for your patience. We have really two awesome announcements we want to talk about. One is coming from our library department, and they have been getting lots of emails from vendors who are letting everyone use their ebook collections. So the library department and our two favorite librarians, Mrs. Faulkner and Mrs. Montino, you can go on their newsletter, and it's a compiled of all the resources are in one place. So keep checking their library website, and then they will also be posting it in the students' Google Classroom in grades 1 through 5.
Perfect. So you can get all of those books that you can read at home, maybe some graphic novels like we talked about yesterday.
Absolutely. And from the Wonderopolis, graphic novels are definitely books. I did learn that. Well, you know, this is making me really sad because I know how hard our art teachers have been working leading up to the art show, which would have been this week. But I have to tell you, there are some amazing moms and dads in the neighborhoods that are trying to bring the art show alive for everyone to see. So over the next several weeks at home, if you would please keep all of your artwork, then Mrs. Gronsky is going to be asking you to then email her. And the hope is that the artwork can hang up outside of your house, and then we can have a walking art show to see what everyone has created during their time at home. You can hang it from your porch, stretch a piece of string between two chairs, hang it from your mailbox. You can get as creative as you want. And if you are participating in it, you will email Nicole Gronsky, which will have her email attached. But you need to let her know by March 28th. This sounds so excited. They're going to make a map.
That's a really, really cool thing. I'm really sad we don't get to see Marching with Ignite this year, but it's definitely going to be a great alternative that we can do in the neighborhoods.
So they'll make a map of it. Make sure you email Mrs. Gronsky by March 28th. Oh, one more thing I forgot. Dr. Sheen and I made a little website on our Midnight page as well that will have our morning announcements and all the resources that we share as well.
Perfect.
Okay, couple other things. We've been getting
lots of stuff. So, Mrs. Hudson, how is Jeremy been doing? I know we've been trying all week to get him to learn to do things that some of our other boys and girls at school and at home have been doing really well with their pets. Give us an update on Jeremy.
So, Gary's doing pretty good. We really haven't mastered sitting yet, but he has improved greatly on not thinking that Cash is a chew toy. So, check out this picture of Cash and Gary, and most importantly, Gary not chewing on Cash. So isn't that good?
That's better.
Gary is not
a lot better.
Absolutely. But we have some pretty, our teachers have some pretty amazing dogs. Check out this hilarious video for Mrs. Sinelli. I always feel like somebody's watching me, and I have no privacy. Oh, I always feel like somebody's watching me. Tell me, is it just a dream? All right, now look how cute Mrs. Regal and Mrs. Tootie's dogs are. It looks like Mrs. Tootie not only has her two babies' diapers to change, but she also has her dog. Good luck, Mrs. Tootie.
Looks like it's a little bit crazy.
All right, so we've been talking a lot about dogs this week. So we were wondering, especially with waffles and chocolate, all the good, the stuff that makes waffles good, we were wondering is why can't dogs eat chocolate? So check out this Wonderopolis app, which will be attached to the video, so you can learn why can't dogs eat chocolate? Can't get that out. Sorry, Dr. Shute there. We'll also be posting today from the Auburn Society of Western Pennsylvania. They started a YouTube channel with daily posts on everything from how to make a homemade woodpecker feeder to a segment on whether a turtle can leave its shell. So that'll will be our discovery or experiment for today.
Wonderful. You know, we actually have a woodpecker that lives near our house and likes to peck at the wood in the corner of our house. And maybe they'll also tell us how we can get rid of that woodpecker and they can find somewhere else to go.
Well, I think animals just love you. They're just attracted to you, Dr. Shute.
I love animals.
You know, the best part of the announcements have been, Dr. Shute, is how many emails we've gotten from parents. We have a list of paws.
There have been an absolute ton, and it's great to hear that everyone is working so hard and doing some of these kind things at home. The first one goes to Noah, who's been so helpful to his sister Quinn and to his parents working from home, and because both his mom and his dad are teachers. So Noah knows what it's really been like to be a helpful hand. Great job, Noah.
This next one goes to Alexis and Zoe for being kind, loving, and helpful to each other.
Lucas in 4D gets a paw from us for helping to move 10 yards of mulch onto their back hill.
10 yards? That's amazing!
That is like muscles right there. Great job, Lucas.
This one goes to James in 2F. He has been helping his mom record videos for her preschoolers. The videos have been about their dog, Bettis, and all of her kids love it.
Wonderful. Elise in 1D is being a great big sister. Great job, Elise.
Ingrid in 1D gets a paw for having a positive attitude through all the changes and bringing joy through artwork into others' lives as well.
Great job. Keely in 5th grade several times this week has taken the mail over to her elderly neighbor's house and also picks up packages for them and takes them over to their house. Great job, Keely.
This one goes to Owen in 5E and Bryn in 2C for being an awesome pair. They are playing so nicely together and being champs through this crazy time. They spent many hours outside in the fresh air making hiking trails, a teepee fort in the woods and in their backyard, and they've even inspired their neighbors to make trails of their own so we can all connect to each other.
Wonderful. And listen to this one. Amelia's Girl Scout group is donating some of their Girl Scout cookies to Passavant Hospital as appreciation for the doctors and the nurses and all those medical staff that are really helping out our fellow community members. Some of those other kids in her Girl Scouts are Ellie in 3A, Alyssa in 3B, Carly in 3A, Charlotte in 3B, Sophia in 3B, and Abby in 3D. Great job, Amelia, and everyone on the Girl Scout troop.
That's amazing, really, responding to all those heroes that are working in the hospitals. This next one goes to Brayden and KB for backing the house and helping his younger sister.
Josh in 4B has been making letters and pictures for his great-grandma. Great job, Josh.
You have to check this picture out that Josh made.
Sweet.
It's an awesome picture. This next one goes to Mason and KF for making cards and helping around the house.
Connor in 1A has also been cleaning the dishes in his room and walking his dog, Iceberg. That's a great name for a dog.
Oh, that is. And then Logan in 5E has been doing a wonderful feeding our large dog, Sadie, helping his mom in the kitchen and doing his schoolwork. And then Mason in 2F has been a big help around the house, feeding our little dog, Tanner, cleaning the table after dinner, and doing his schoolwork. Way to go, boys. All right, you have to check out these two pictures. This is pretty cool. Ronan and Torin were on a hike today, and they noticed, well, yesterday, and there was a lot of garbage along the path. The boys decided they want to clean it up, so they got help from Oma to find gloves and bags and went back to the path to pick up the trash. Isn't that awesome?
That is a great job. Great job, Torin. Great job, Torin, for keeping our earth clean.
All right, Henry Goheen, he is pretty hilarious. He, one of his fit activities, he kind of took it to a new level. He said, check out this new board I made for math from the fit menu. I added all the math facts and I wrote directions and had some geometry to make homemade dice. He's rocking FID. Look at this awesome picture.
I think he might be a future teacher.
I think so. I think it's in his jeans.
I think so.
And then look at this picture up from Carly in 3A and Patrick in 1D, who made hand sanitizer.
Yay! Oh, great.
That's an amazing job. So, boys and girls, today is Wednesday, which is always our Be Our Kind Kin Day. So make sure you're extra kind today at home with mom and dad and whoever you are with. And we have a story that we forgot yesterday, but check out the story from Pete the Cat Got Class. The link will be attached. We hope you have a wonderful Wednesday. Anything else, Dr. Shoot?
Just have a great day, and hopefully you can eat some of those waffles for breakfast, maybe lunch, maybe dinner, maybe all three times.
And after you eat them, it's workout. Right? They can do some ab work. They can work out, right? Work off the waffles.
Absolutely.
All right, have a great night. Great day, McKnight.
Have a great day, McKnight.